Joe's pleasure, pal. It's Vito speaking.
Vito, why didn't you come home last night? I was worried sick.
Mama? I didn't know you had Joe's number. And whose phone is this?
So have you spoken to Mr. Pappalardo? Find yourself a job?
Yeah, he told me to come by and see him today. Hopefully he's got some work for me.
Okay, Vito. Good luck, mio bambino.
All right, bye, Mama.
Oh, hi there.
What's the matter? Nothing good on the radio?
Mind your beeswax, kid.
If you don't turn that crap down, I'm gonna call the cops!
That's why you might consider substituting horse meat for chicken, pork, and even beef.
If you don't turn that crap down, I'm gonna call the cops!
Horse filet mignon, or many other horse meat recipes available from your local...
If you don't turn that crap down, I'm gonna call the cops!
I'm holding you responsible, questioning for all the damage you...
Thank you. Close the door. It's windy. What do you want?
Yeah, I'm looking for a Mr. Papalotto.
Oh, yeah? Why?
My name's Vito Scaletta. My old man used to work for him, and I'm looking for a job, so I came here.
Well, you're in the right spot, sonny boy. Federico Papalotto at your service. You can call me Derek. I think I remember your dad. Good guy, but drank like a fish. What's he up to these days?
He's dead.
Oh, well, we all gotta go sometime. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
So you need a job, huh? Well, you're in luck. We just got a new shipment to unload. Steve will show you around. Now scram, my steak's getting cold.
Follow me. Load this pile of crates onto that truck. When you're done, you get $10. If something gets lost or broken, you get nothing. Start now and don't take all day.
Oh, yeah, this is gonna be a lot of fun. Who the fuck wants to move boxes around all goddamn day?
Hey, you done?
Yeah, I'm done. And you can keep the $10. When I said I needed a job, I didn't mean slave labor.
Whatever. Get the fuck out of here, then. Don't show your face around here again.
Yeah, don't worry. I can make 100 times more working for Barbaro Incorporated.
Wait, you said Barbaro? Joe Barbaro?
Yeah, so what?
Shit. Nobody who works with Joe would carry crates for $10. What the hell are you doing? Come with me.
What now?
Well, this one don't like manual labor.
What the fuck?
Said he works with Joe Barbaro.
Bullshit. Who wanna load crates if he works with Joe? You'll have to explain this one to me, sonny boy. What's your story?
Well, my mother wanted me to come talk to you about an honest job, but I need some real money, so this ain't gonna cut it.
Them women, they're all the same. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
She doesn't want you hanging around with Joe, right? My mother was the same way. Look what become of me. Union boss. I got the whole fucking waterfront under my thumb. So how's Joe?
Pretty good, I guess.
How'd you meet up with him?
Oh, we go way back to the old neighborhood. I just come back from overseas and he's putting me up until I can get back on my feet.
Listen, you gotta understand, a person in my position has gotta be careful.
Certainly.
So you won't mind if I give Joe a call, right?
Nah, go ahead.
Now, where'd I put his number? Hey, here it is. He might not be home. That wouldn't be good. Hi, Joe. Hey, this is Derek. Listen, I got this guy here. What'd you say your name was?
Vito.
Vito. He's looking for a job. He says he's a friend of yours. A good friend. I just wanted to check with you first. Uh-huh. Sure. War hero and all that shit. All right. Thanks, then. I'll talk to you later. Sorry, pal. I had to check you out. Joe says you just come back from Italy. You must be able to handle yourself. You want to make a little more money? I got just the thing. The guys here at the port are supposed to pay a monthly fee to the barber, but half of them never cough it up. I need someone to give them a little nudge. $10 a man.
What if they don't need a haircut?
Well, then you'll have to convince them otherwise.
I see. What if somebody makes a fuss?
Then you kick the shit out of them.
Well, let's say you teach them a lesson that doesn't require that they miss work. You got it? Which is why Steve ain't doing the job. Right, Steve?
Right, boss.
Collect at least $150, I give you 50. Just for walking around, taking in the Sierra, meeting new people. Easy fucking money, eh? What do you say?
Yeah, hey, it's better than lugging crates around.
All right, then. Get going.
I'm here to collect the fee for the barber.
Hey, what kind of game you playing here?
The kind where you pay what you owe and you don't get hurt. You got a problem with that?
I got a problem with you. Now get out of here before I kick your ass.
Here's your fucking money.
Yeah, glad you decided to reconsider. Hey, pal. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Yeah. I must have forgot or something.
Next time, try to pay on time, okay? Thanks. Hey, Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Sure, here it is. I don't want no problems.
Don't leave it until the last minute next time. Hey, pal. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Look, asshole. I'm not in the mood. Why don't you get out of my face before you get hurt?
No can do, pal. Derek wants his money.
Derek can kiss my ass. What's that fat fuck gonna do? Have me killed?
Hey, you said it, not me.
Why don't you give it a try then, asshole?
Kick the shite out of him!
Anybody else got a fucking problem with paying for the fucking barber?
This guy already paid. I got his money already. Here's the money, boss man.
Good job. Here's your share. I watched you take care of Bill. You were good. Steve damn near got his ass kicked when he tried that. Right, Steve?
Yeah, right, Derek.
Here's a bonus for sorting him out.
Thanks.
The guy's been a real fucking pain.
Now get out of here, kid. I gotta be getting back to business. Say hello to your mother for me. Tell her you got yourself a job as my new assistant.
Yeah, will do. I'll see you later.
And Vito, I almost forgot. Joe called. He wants you should meet him at Freddy's.